Hey everybody, it's Rob with Park Industries. Back here once again on the Titan 3700. I get a lot of questions from people about how fast will a machine produce parts? What can I expect off that machine? So today, we're gonna do something a little bit different for you. Well, we've loaded up a table here with about 70 square feet of vanities. I've got a dozen 37 inch vanities, so I've got a dozen Kohler 2210 sinkholes. It's gonna be equivalent of 122 lineal feet, so it's pretty tightly packed. And we're gonna run this stuff at speeds approaching 600 inches a minute or better. That's gonna develop into a program that I think you'll see finish in about 2 hours and 45 minutes, roughly. In the past, it took us way over 4.5 hours to do the same table run. Now this is gonna get time-lapsed, so it'll be a little faster. It won't take you a couple hours to sit here and watch this, but you're gonna get to see the full run through. At the end, we'll go take a close look and see what the finished product looks like. To get this process started, all I gotta do is come hit the little green button, cycle start. Here we go. All right guys, so let's talk a little bit about what you're seeing here while the machine's running. This very first initial pass is actually gonna come and do our wall scribes for each of those vanities. That can, you know, if you're out there templating and you're catching irregularities, you're gonna wanna do a wall scribe so you can set that top right next to the wall. If you're doing commercial work where you're doing cutting stuff for a Menards or a Home Depot and they're pre-packaging them, or any other box store or entity out there that would do that, you'd probably just cut that straight and you'd eliminate that one pass. Now you're gonna see that tool come in and you're gonna hit the three sides that we're actually gonna polish, as well as the sink. And basically what we're doing is, on the saw jet, we oversized all of these parts so that we could utilize the overhead laser for placing all of them on our table. Well, when we use an overhead laser, we have an accuracy of about 1/16 of an inch. So we've got to allow a little bit of room for play in there, and then we can bring all that material down to the exact size that we need with this tool. So now that we've done that, we're to come back with our very first shape tool. Now, position number one typically doesn't run real fast. It's gonna be about 120, 125 inches a minute. And that's our first metal bond. Typically, that's gonna take off the most material, so it's gonna come in a little bit slower than the rest of the stuff. Now you're gonna see the high-speed tools come into play. They're gonna come in on positions 2 and 3 at about 600 inches a minute or better. So they'll come in a little slower as they get onto the stone, and then they will ramp up right away to a high speed, and they'll have to decelerate right away at the end. This is gonna happen quick, so if you watch close, you'll see those rapid movements. What we've done on the Titan 3700 series to allow all this is we opened up the water flow. So we brought larger water lines in. We're now throwing roughly about 20 gallons a minute of water at these tools between the external water ring and our center water feed. This high water flow allows us to remove that excess material quickly and rapidly as these tools are moving at much, much higher speeds than what the past basic high-speed tools were running, roughly in that 180 inches a minute.
In our old machines running the half-inch lines, we were maxing out at about, well, probably 12 to 14 gallons a minute.
So if that's something of interest to you and you own an earlier version Titan, say a 17 or 1800 or a 27 or 2800, you can contact Park in the service department and they can sell you a kit to upgrade your machine so that you can run these high-speed tools on that machine as well. something that, you know, for all of you who run hand labor in your shops or have run smaller versions of some of these machines, the beauty of being able to have a large table design and load it up like this is the ability of freedom. You can set this table up, you can hit the green cycle start button, and you've got an hour and a half to 2 hours of free time to go back and do whatever else you need to do as a business owner or a business manager or an operations guy or whatever position you handle. You can be more effective in your job by having this extra time built in. What you'll also notice on the 3700 here is we've got an awful lot of parts and an awful lot of vacuum cups. So if you're thinking that you're going to buy a machine and you're going to load it up to the absolute max like this, make sure you talk to your sales rep about getting enough vacuum cups and enough manifolds to service that entire tabletop. A lot of times you'll get a basic package that's going to offer you, say, 20 to 25 vacuum cups. In a situation like this, you're probably going to want to have 30 plus cups. And I can tell you that the 200 by 200 and the 200 by 400 are by far the most valuable cups you'll see out there. We utilized as many of those as we could on these parts today.
As we come to the next positions, our final metal bond here is going to come in a little bit slower. So we want to make sure that we get a good final pass with this metal bond tool before we bring in our polishers. We have the polish side or the finish side down. And the reason that we do that is because that surface we know is flat and true. So if we put that side down on our vacuum cups, we know that as our tools come through, we're going to have a perfectly straight top line.
Let's just a quick little dissertation here between the difference of a 3700 and a 3800. The two main differences you're going to see are going to be table size. A 3700, as we spoke earlier, is 8 feet deep by 14 and a half feet wide for the work table. And as we move up to the 3800, it's going to be 8 feet deep by 16 feet wide. So you're going to gain about 12 square feet on that work table, which if you look at the example that we're running today, it would equate to allowing you to run two more of those vanity tops over there. Two of the larger ones would fit in. The second thing that you'll notice is going to be tool capacity. On the 3700, we do our tools on the sides of the machine. So we're basically running 18 positions on each side. When we go to a 3800, we've actually got a tool rack that bolts onto the back of the machine, and we run 68 tools on that. The second benefit of that is when the machine splits in half, it actually allows you to get that larger machine through a 10-foot doorway. Where with a 3700, it's going to require that you have a 12-foot wide doorway to get that machine in. So something to take in mind or keep in mind as you're looking at your shop and you're looking at your doorways and the access in there. How's a rigger going to get this machine in? 12-foot wide for your 3700 series, 10-foot wide for your 3800 series. But if you look at the layout, the 3800 will take up a much larger footprint when the two parts are bolted together.
All right, guys, so there you have it. These are beautiful crisp edges on here. The tooling works wonderful. We ran some really nice high speeds on number 2 and number 3. It's amazing. I'd really like to thank all you guys for paying attention to our demo. Other than that, I look forward to helping people get into the next generation of Titans. Thanks again, guys.